Hey, good morning to you. God bless you this morning. It's good to see you today. Happy Easter. Happy Resurrection Sunday morning. Amen. Let's thank the Lord. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Amen. Good to see you today. I'm Pastor Gary. You're at Fellowship Church. I'm running late because we had a really big crowd at the beach this morning. It was great. I mean, yeah, thank the Lord for that. That was great. Tell you that right now. I mean, it's like a crusade almost. And I gave the gospel just very clear. And the idea was nothing is holding you back. That's what the resurrection is all about. Jesus Christ died on a cross, rose from the grave. There's nothing holding you back from being a Christian, from being saved, from having your sins forgiven. But we think, you know, our past, or this happened to me, or that happened to me, or struggles in life. Nothing is holding you back. He tore the bars away. Amen? And he rose from the grave. That's why this day is so incredible, so significant. And I really made that very, very, very clear. And it was very clear. It was great. And I could just feel it. You know what I'm saying? And many came to Christ this morning. Let's thank the Lord. Many came to Christ today. It was incredible. It was incredible. I loved it. It was incredible. I love it. They lift their hand up, and I tell them, man, I'm straight up with them. Amen? But I felt really, didn't y'all feel that today? Well, it was incredible. Real peaceful down there. They're singing, birds flying. How many were there? A lot of y'all were there. Look, am I telling the truth? Unbelievable. And then they're singing, and you know there's doves, but then there's the ringneck turtle doves. And they flew right behind and sat right, they're flying. They sat, they're singing, there's the dove just sitting right behind them. And the sun's coming up over here. Now, this is a movie, I'm telling you right now. And they were singing like professionals they are, amen. It was beautiful. It was fantastic. So great, 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 great day, man. We're already off and running. But welcome today, and I'll hush now, and let's get going. Y'all ready or not? Amen. Let's thank the Lord. Come on. One more time. Thank the Lord with me. Yeah. Amen. Now, we got several songs. I know we're talking, but this is how we're doing it today, I think. What are we going to start off with?
Let's do Oh Praise the Name.
Oh Praise the Name. Then what do you think you want to follow with? How about Forever?
All right.
Let's do that. Oh Praise the Name and Forever. We're going to do both of those, and we're going to be on our feet. Amen. And that's going to get us started. How many were here on Good Friday concert? Wow, man. Y'all are troopers, man. Thank you. Well, how many definitely want to hear that Via Dolorosa again? Whoa, look at the hands went up. You're going to hear that today. Now, guys, listen, I'm going to ask for some music today. I'm going to ask a little bit, okay? And I don't know what I'm going to ask, so just get ready. Yes. I'm going to tell you right now, Mitch and Sherry, they sang this morning down at the beach, and they didn't miss a note. I'm going to tell you right now. They were strong. That song Redeemer that Mitchell did, and we'll need to hear that here this morning, son. We'll need to hear Redeemer in this room. Amen. Let's get up on our feet. We're ready to have church on an Easter Sunday morning. Come on. Will you bend your neck around and look around? We always have good crowds here. We're grateful. But I like you to look. Why? It just tells me America has hope. There's hope. There's hope in this room. That's what this does. You can listen to the news. You can see all the bad. And it is bad. It ain't right. A lot of it ain't. But this is the difference right here. You can make a difference. We can't fix everything, but we sure can do something here where we live. Amen? And we can make a difference right here. Take time to love on people. Man, it's a good thing, man. This is the only thing I know. I don't know any other answer. This is the answer. Jesus Christ. But it's you are the answer. Loving each other. Caring for one another, man. Not running out. I know we have to run sometimes, but sometimes we got to slow down and put our arm around. Like I did this lady. That's why I'm late. This lady in a wheelchair wanted to meet me, and she's just crying. And she's probably 70, I'm guessing. I don't know. I put my arm around her. She's soft. But she's got a big surgery coming up, and she was struggling, and I could love on her. But guess what happened when I loved on her? She did what? She loved on me, and I didn't care about being late anymore. Amen? So we want to love people, baby. That's what we want to do. Amen? But also, We need to let them know the truth. And the truth is that Jesus is the only way. He's the only way to God the Father. You got to put your faith in Christ. Amen. It's a good thing. It's the best thing. Amen. One last thing. Let's put our hands together. Thank God we live in America. Come on. Here we go. Don't give up. Here we go. Now we're turning. It's all about Him. Here we go. Let's sing about it right now. Oh, praise the name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Come on. Thank you for being here.
I cast my mind on Calvary, with Jesus bled and died for me. I see His robe, His hands, His feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid Him down in Joseph's tomb. The entrance sealed by heavy stone, Messiah stood and all alone. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God. Oh, praise His name forevermore. Oh, for endless days we will sing Your praise. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord our God.
And on the third, and on the third, at break of dawn, the Son of Heaven rose again. Oh, trampled death, where is Your sting? Oh, the angels roar.
Oh, praise the name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Come on. Boy, it is nice to hear you sing. Now, Sherry's going to lead out on this one. It's called Forever. What a great, great, great Resurrection Sunday morning song. Amen. Appreciate it. Appreciate you guys singing your heart out today. I know. I'm hoarse and I ain't done half what y'all have done.
Because you sang your heart out at the first service.
Well, I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm with you. Amen. Come on. Forever. Forever. Here we go. Praise the Lord. Amen. There we go. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Moon and stars, they went. The morning sun was still. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, his blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon. Heaven looked away, the Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broken. And then the ground began to shake, the stone perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated. Forever He is glorified.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Wow. That's up there. Hey, you need some water. Amen. Praise the Lord. Again, thank you for being here today. God bless you. Apologize. I got something in my mouth, and it's going to be that way probably all morning. Amen. I've had a little bug. I don't have fever or nothing like that. I've had a bad cough. But it's getting better, though, this morning, thankfully. Amen. Glad you're here today. God bless you. I'm going to tell you like I told that early crowd this morning. Nothing is holding you back. Nothing. There's nothing holding you back today from putting your faith and trust in Christ. That doesn't mean there's not something you think it is. But the way God sees it, everything's been done. Everything's been done for to have your sins forgiven. Your name can be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. We're not talking about playing church. We're talking about a total transformation from death to life, from hell to heaven. And God wants that for you today. That's His perfect will for your life. He's not willing any should perish. And so today is your day. You're here. And you might have came kicking and screaming, but buddy, you made it. Amen. First time I went to church, I didn't just come kicking and screaming. I came cussing. It was terrible. But you're here today, and God loves you right where you are and as you are, and nothing's standing in the way. He took it all out of the way so you could be saved today. Let's pray together. Lord, thank you for loving us. Lord, love that we have no idea this kind of love even existed, that the Creator of the universe would make us in His own image and would love us so much, even though we're sinners and screw-ups, many of us. And you loved us so much that you would give your own son to die on a cross for us. It's crazy. And so, God, I pray today, help us. Help us to absolutely know beyond a shadow of any doubt that Jesus, you're our Savior, you're our Lord, that we believe in you and no one else. Lord, I pray that for everybody today, here or watching online. I pray we'll not let an incredible day like this pass, thinking, oh, I'll just do it another day or next year. We don't know what tomorrow's going to bring. Lord, touch people today. Save people today. And help all of us to double down, triple down on our faith in you and to live out our faith before others. We don't want to have church without you, Lord. We know where two or three are gathered in your name, Jesus. You're in the middle of us. And so, Lord, we are here in your name. Be with us, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Be seated. If you would, Mr. Alexander Christie, got a big day, but we're already making it through it.
Yes, sir. Go get them. Good morning, everybody, and thank you so much for being here this morning, and happy Easter. We're so grateful you're here. If today's your first time here, please do us a favor and fill out the guest registry. That's right there in your worship guide that you got when you came in this morning. Or you can meet us out at the Welcome Center after the service and just basically fill out the same basic info, and we'll give you a little gift bag with some stuff about the church, some cool sunglasses, a little notepad, some pens. We promise not to bug you. We just want to send you a note of thanks for being here this week, as well as a postcard whenever a big event is coming up here at the church. If you don't mind doing that this morning, we really would appreciate it. And good morning, everyone online. Thank you for tuning in. Happy Easter to you. We ask you to do us a favor, please, and send us a Facebook message or an email, and we'll do the same thing for you. We have baptisms tonight down at Englewood Beach. We are super excited to have a great evening at the beach starting at 5 o'clock. But the great news is if you come to the Publix parking lot over by Bell's, Merchants Crossing Publix, they are closed today. They close for Easter and Christmas. And we are able to use that parking lot, and we're going to have a big bus come through and give you a ride at 3 o'clock, at 3:30, at 4 o'clock, 4:30, and then up until 5 o'clock, we'll be giving you a ride down to the beach, and then we'll even bring you back numerous times throughout the course of the evening in case you're not able to stay the entire time. It's just a great chance for you to come out, not have to worry about the parking, not have to worry about all that good stuff. Just come out and have a carefree evening with us, celebrating the Lord, and then celebrating people who are being baptized. It's going to be a beautiful night for baptism. The weather's going to be beautiful, and we're cooking out on the grill for you. We ask you to bring a side dish, please. We're providing the main meal and the dessert, but please bring a side dish tonight. We would really appreciate that. And come on out. You want to bring an extra chair or something like that? You can, but we're going to be setting things up a little bit different. So we're going to be able to utilize a little more of that pavilion out there as well. So it's going to be a great evening tonight. If you get baptized tonight, you're going to get a great keepsake necklace that is made by a beautiful couple here in our church, as well as a necklace cross, yes, sir, and as well as a beautiful beach towel from Fellowship Church. We'd love for you to come on out tonight, please. Amen. Friend to friend, every single Tuesday right here at Fellowship Church, come on out on a Tuesday afternoon to make some new friends. Divorce care every Wednesday at 4 o'clock here at Fellowship Church. Give us a call at the office if you have any questions about this great support group. And then also at 4 o'clock, we have our grief share for folks that are grieving. Starts at 4 o'clock. Also, please give us a call at the office if you have questions. Both of those end at 6 o'clock, right in time for an incredible meal out in the foyer for our Celebrate Recovery group, which is all about getting you closer to the Lord and using the Lord to help strengthen you to get through your hurts, your hangups, and any struggles you may go through in your life with addiction, to pain, to anything you've got going. So please come out on Wednesday for a great service. And we have our Monday night Bible study starting tomorrow night. If you, I think there might be a couple spots. I saw Miss Chrissy out there earlier today. And if you haven't gotten your book yet, see her after the service. We'd love for you to come on out. If you signed up, please be there tomorrow. And then on Wednesday, we have that second half of the Genesis started study. Come on out on Wednesday, ladies, especially if you signed up. And if you haven't signed up, she's got some books left. So we'd love for you to come on out and dedicate some time to learning more about this great book. And as always, we thank you so much for supporting a Fellowship Church, wearing the shirts, wearing the hats, the bumper stickers, all that good stuff. That's why we had a huge crowd of people down at the beach this morning already. And we have so many folks here today because they saw a bumper sticker, they saw a t-shirt. Please help us out. Do your part with that. And thank you for giving at Fellowship Church. If you don't mind, just checking out give2fc.com. Super easy way to give online. We're a debt-free ministry because of your giving. We thank you so very much for that. And that P.O. box, many of you will be heading north, which we hate. We really hate that. Absolutely. Strong word, but we mean it. We hate that you head back north, but we know you're heading back north. And we just appreciate all of you that send us notes of encouragement, letting us know that you're coming back. And we just really, really love that filling that P.O. box up with that love. And the hospitality is going to be available right after this service. Please go on over. It's all for free. We'd love for you to make a new fellowship friend today. And one little thing also, please, if you'd like to be part of Senior Fellowship, coming up on the third Thursday of month, please sign up on your way out today. We'd love to have you be a part of that as well. It's coming up pretty quick. Amen, buddy. We love and appreciate you. Have a great morning and happy Easter to you.
Amen. Good job. You're probably hoping I take longer.
Yeah. Band, I'm going to tell you, he sped through them pretty quick. So band, on alert, on alert, on alert, on alert. Amen. Tonight, we got a big service tonight. And it's a little different. It looks like there could be some rain in the forecast. But I told the crowd this morning, if it rains tonight, I'm going to do a rain dance. I mean, my yard, ain't just dirt, it's dust now. It's just dust. So we need rain bad, don't we? So if it rains on Easter, that's a gift. We're not looking at that as a bad thing. But we do have that big covered pavilion down there. But if you feel free to ride down there and see if there's parking. But otherwise, just meet us there at that Publix, and you can get on. It's not just a shuttle bus. It's a big tour bus. I mean, you're going to wish it was a longer ride. You're only going to be on like 5 minutes. You're just getting comfortable. But they got the big thing underneath. You can put your chair and mess like that you want to bring stuff to the beach. So don't let that stop you. You'll park right there, 3:30, 4:30, because you might want to get there a little early. Just enjoy. That's fine. Why not? It's Easter Sunday. Amen. And you have a drink or something like that, bring that. And just enjoy the time together tonight. And then we'll have the cookout starting at 5:30. We'll try to be sharp on that if we can. And we'll have communion tonight, communion right on the beach. We'll make our way, and we'll just have a good time. Looking forward to it, then we'll baptize. I think we have about a dozen already that want to follow the Lord in baptism. And if it's raining, or you see that on your phone, shut your phone off. What did we do before we had them? Light rain, weather. I mean, we went with, you know, whatever. I mean, man, my gosh, it's crazy. And the way it's been lately, they've said we're going to have rain, and we ain't seen it, all right? So if I was you, I'd just stay steady, amen? But anyway, so that's tonight. Looking forward to a great evening. Mitchell Clark.
What do you want? You're the DJ.
You're it. You're right there.
Perfect.
You're ready. You just need a microphone, and you need that lady right over there.
Perfect.
Let's thank the Lord for Mitchell Clark and Karen Simpson.
Sun, where to stand in the morning, and who told the ocean you can only come this far, and who showed the moon where till evening, whose words alone can catch a falling star? Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let our creation testify that this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. The very same God that spins things runs to the weary, the worn and the weak, in the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken. Oh, they conquered death to bring me victory. The payment for my sin was the precious life he gave. Oh, but now he's alive and there's an empty grave.
What an incredible Easter Sunday morning song, my brother. Love you. Proud of you. Proud of you, man. Tell you that right now. Praise the Lord. Amen. What a great song for our heart. Amen. Amen. Y'all be seated. You're going to get another one. Here's another one coming. Amen. We're going to do Via Dolorosa. Via Dolorosa's coming. Amen. Come on. Now, this has a surprise in it. This song has a surprise in it. I heard her sing this the other night at the concert, and I was like, wow. So if you didn't hear it, you're fixing to hear it. A surprise is coming. It's something I know I couldn't do. You'll find out when it happens. Amen. Wow. Thank you. Mitch has been singing that song, I Know My Redeemer Lives, for probably at least 20 years, if not 25 years. And that means he started that when he was about 10, 11 years old, singing that song, and has been doing it with me at the beach for at least 20 years. And that's crazy. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's crazy. It's a long time, man. Praise the Lord. Miss Sherry is going to lead this out and have some help from Mitch as well. But again, let's just thank the Lord for the three of them right there. Amen. This morning. Praise the Lord. I like to say thank you. That's a good thing. Amen. Come on.
Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear the narrow streets, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary.
He was bleeding from a beating. There were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head. And he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love. Oh, you and me, down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary.
Oh, la via dolorosa, triste allí en Jerusalén. Los solares le abren paso a Jesús, mas la gente se acercaba para ver que iba a aquella cruz. Oh, la via dolorosa, que es la vía del dolor. Como veo vino Cristo, Rey Señor, y fue quien quiso ir por su amor por ti.
Incredible. Wow. What a blessing, huh? I love that. Come on. Amen. Stay on up on your feet if you can. Get on up with me. Amen. One last time this morning. Well, have you enjoyed the music this morning, this service? Amen. What a blessing. What a blessing. Amen. What a blessing, man. All right. So, Mitch, what is it? What is it? One last song.
I know, I was thinking of switching it up.
What are you thinking?
Resurrecting.
Let's do it.
Resurrecting.
We gotta find it.
You gotta find it? I'll talk. Hey, now I've got something to say. I do. Hey, thank you. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work here at Fellowship Church. On Friday evening, if we have extra events and things like that, like I had at the beach this morning, I like to let the crowds there know that really the funds are for something for the future. And so this morning at the beach, that offering went to our kids' wing. And any bit helps, man. You hear me? And like on Friday evening, I think about $6,000 came in for that project. Amen. That's a lot. That's great money, man. That's fantastic. Amen. Tell you what, man, when you're building a building, when we get to that point, we'll think, man, $6,000 will buy some stuff. Amen. And man, we just keep rolling with it, keep going. So to this morning, so at the beach, so I don't know anything about all that, what the folks gave there, but it wouldn't surprise me if it wasn't a pretty nice offering down there that's going to help our kids wing, amen? But in this, today, this service, the next service, this offering will go to meet the needs of our ministry and what we do here. And just, you know, just keep things going. What we don't do here is pay any debt, amen? We don't pay any interest. And boy, aren't you glad? Aren't you glad? Aren't you glad? Because a church might have a moving interest rate. They're hard to, sometimes church is hard to get it locked in. You know what I mean? And matter of fact, when you borrow for a church, they charge you more interest because it's such a great risk to lend to a church. Okay? So we just take all that out of the way. We just say, okay, how about we don't borrow nothing from you? How about that? How about we raise the funds? And that's what we've done here. Everything you see is debt-free. But it's not just debt-free. We did it without cheating people. You hear me or not? That makes us a step above, I'd say. And we also did it without making people feel like dirt. Like if you don't give, you're not a good Christian. We're not doing any of that garbage here. You hear me, yes or no? Okay? Here, if you can give, we ask you to give cheerfully. If for some reason you can't do that, we ask you to keep it. Hang on to it. Or, in some cases, you're a single mom, you're somebody struggling, man, you need to pay your bills, man. And that, you know, I tell people for years, it's a wonder we ain't broke. You know what I mean? But the opposite's true. Fellowship Church is blessed. Amen? And God gets all the what? He gets all the credit and glory. Amen? So that offering's coming up in just a bit. And how'd I do with my talking? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Aren't you glad you have me sometimes?
Yeah. It's a great wild card.
It's a great wild card, he said. Come on. Here we go. Let's sing Resurrecting this morning. Amen. One last song with the band today. Praise the Lord.
The head that once was crowned with thorns is crowned with glory now.
Sorry, Raj. The
a Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at His feet we bow. The one who wore our singing chain, now robed in majesty. The radiance of perfect love now shines for all to see. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Oh, your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. The fear that held us now gives way to Him who is our peace. His final breath upon that cross is now alive in me. Your name. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Oh, your name is victory. Oh, all praise will rise to Christ our King. By your Spirit.
Church.
To declare your victory.
Victory. Amen. The resurrected,
resurrected King.
King
is resurrected.
Come on.
By your Spirit,
I will rise
from the ashes.
Amen.
Of oh, the resurrected King is resurrecting me. In your name I come alive
to declare
your victory.
Thank you, Lord.
Resurrected King, oh, is resurrecting me. Oh, is resurrecting me. The tomb where soldiers watched it.
Sing it, church, with us.
Was borrowed for 3 days. His body there would not remain.
Sing it, come on.
Yet our God has robbed the grave.
Come on, sing it out. Go ahead.
Our God has robbed the grave.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Your name is victory. Your praise will rise to Christ our King. Oh, your name is victory. Oh, your praise will rise to Christ our King. By your Spirit I will rise from the ashes.
I love this. Come on. Thank you, Lord.
Is resurrecting me.
You're good
in
to
your
us.
Name I come alive to declare your victory. Oh, the resurrecting King, oh, is resurrecting me.
I'd say that was a pretty good day at the Fellowship Church. Come on. Amen. Wow. Y'all are lucky I got a bad throat today. I mean, I would be so loud it ain't even funny. But again, thank you, thank you, thank you for giving to the Lord's work. And buddy, Cornell, how you doing, buddy? Come on, I want you to pray for us. Come on. Thank you for giving to the Lord's work here and the offering. And Cornell, I've loved this man for a few years. Good man right here. But you would say you're not a good man, right?
No, I'm not.
That's right. I knew that.
He is. Amen.
The Lord's good. That's right. Born in Romania. Came to this country.
Yes.
Had nothing.
Only for freedom.
Only for freedom.
Yeah. Good to be in America.
Good to be America.
Yes, man.
Must really break your heart to see what's happening today in this world.
It is, it is.
It's crazy, ain't it?
Yeah, it is.
Amen.
I've been to Ukraine last year for 2 months just to help the people in need. So.
Yes, sir.
But hey, we're blessed to be here.
Blessed to be here.
Amen.
And Cornell is part of a ministry. What's the name of the ministry?
Partners in Evangelism International.
Partners in Evangelism International. It's a mission organization with a lot of missionaries, and Cornell's right out of our church. He came here from, was it Illinois?
Yeah, well, Chicago.
Chicago area. Came to this area from Chicago, and got it.
Left the Democrats.
Yes, I hear you. No. It's rough. Well, you left crime when you left Chicago, I'll tell you that. It's sad, ain't it? Sad, really is. But the thing is, this man right here leads this organization. They have many missionaries. We support them. But the beautiful thing is, we're blessed to have him right out of our church and his wife. Amen. So keep them in your, thank the Lord. Keep them in your prayers. Amen. Come on, right here. Amen. But anyway, I'm going to go to Ukraine. I've been there before. I'm going to go to Romania with you because I've been there several times. But I've made a commitment that I'm going to go with you. I got my passport. Anyway, it was expired. But I'm going to go with you. Got it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to try to drag Mitchell with me.
Please do.
No, but if I drag Mitchell, you're going to have trouble. I'm just saying with you.
Oh, yeah? That's okay.
That boy don't do nothing but argue. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah. But anyway, it's going to be good. Thank you for giving to God's work today. Pray for us.
What a blessing time, Father. First of all, to know that you are our Father. Mm. And what a blessing to be here this morning to celebrate that you send your son to not only die, but rose again for our sins. And wow, we can raise with him, just be there with him. Wow, what a blessings. We can't even express. Father, we just thank you for this offering that you're providing for the church, for the administration, for whatever, all the needs. Father, we just bless. We are blessed country. So bless each one of us right here. And this morning, Father, we just want to give you praise for who you are. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. All right, see you, buddy boy. God bless you. Amen. Amen. He's trying to preach. Trying to preach. I can hear him. Okay, there you go. Amen. For you that are watching online, thank you so much for tuning us in. Had a big, big crowd on Friday night online. Incredible. Thank you. But thank you for giving, too. Your giving makes a difference. You wonder sometimes, what do I give? Is it going to make a difference? I tell you what, you're helping this congregation here, the online group, the congregation there. You're a big blessing. We appreciate you. Thank you.
We have hundreds watching
today. Thank you, buddy. Amen. A lot of folks watching this morning. Thank you so much. Would you write me a note right now, a note of encouragement? Say something nice. If you don't, we'll erase it. No, we won't. I'll write you back. You don't want to say nothing, okay? Anyway, now I won't write you back. I'll talk about you publicly. Appreciate it. Thank you. All right, she's got an old song over here, and I can't see. Here we go. What is it? What's the first word? Oh, I know that one. God sent his son. They called him Jesus. He came to heal, love and forgive. He lived and died to be my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives. Come on. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds my future, and life is worth the living just because he lives. Let's thank the Lord for Miss Karen, everybody serving us, the people that made the beach service possible. Oh, man. I'm sitting there this morning. I'm watching. Man, I mean, I didn't do anything but show up and speak. But it takes a lot to make that beach service happen like we did today. I mean, it's crazy. Of course, I'm a worry wart. I'm worried if everybody's going to do what they're supposed to do, you know. But guess what? Everybody did. And same here. There's so much going on here. People wonder if we have kids' ministries. Yeah, we got kids' ministries. They're behind that big wall right there. All right? And there's all kinds of stuff going on. And, you know, how you take up an offering and who deals with all that. You know, I ain't never went and got one donut. Well, I used to get donuts when we started the church, but I don't do any of that. And it all just happens, doesn't it? We have communion. We see, 500 cups, 600 cups. How does that happen? It takes people, man. Amen? And great people. Let's thank the Lord for it. It takes great people. Great people. Amen. That's what makes a church, man. And the Bible, the word churches means called out assembly. We've been called out. What does that mean? We've been called forth to follow him. That's God's will for everybody. But that's the church. We're local. And we're just a group of folks that get together in Jesus' name. Amen. And makes it happen. Day like today really highlights that. And then the band, the time that it takes to put into, to be a live band, to pull that off, that's no slim deal there. That takes work, man. I've been a musician singer for years. And I know sometimes the hours it takes just to get a song right. And so you don't slide off your note into la-la land. You know what I mean? It is crazy. But anyway, let's go to the message. Here we go. Not long. Let's go, Raj. Can't be long. Amen. Jesus gets me. What is it? 35 right now? Is it 9:35? 36? Be quiet. Good grief. Say that out loud. Jesus what? He gets me. I want to look at it from a different angle today. A little different. You're going to see why he gets you and why he gets me, and nobody else can. You're going to see why nobody else can be your Savior and your Lord. Nobody's going to ever get you like he gets you and understands you and understands what you're going through. You're going to see it. Here it is. He gets me. Now, last week, we gave a whole message on that, how that we don't have a Savior who hasn't been touched with our feelings. But in all points, he was tempted and tested just like we are, yet without sin. And so, as we took you through Passion Week, how he asked his disciples to pray for him and in the garden, just watch with me for an hour. And he kept sleeping. He must have felt so unloved. I felt that. And then he was betrayed by Judas. I've been betrayed. He knows what it feels like. Peter denied him, but it says all the disciples forsook him and fled. I've had people forsake me. Do you understand how he gets us, yes or no? Humiliated? He was humiliated. They stripped him naked. That's not happened to me by somebody forcing that on me. But many in this room, that has happened to you. He gets you. He feels you. Remember that? He feels you. To be abused, I've suffered some abuse in my life. He was abused. I mean, he gets us. That's what I mean by this series. Rejected. His own father turned his face away when he was on the cross. And Jesus cried, my God, why have you forsaken me? I've been rejected. Do you understand where I'm coming from, yes or no? So he gets us. We don't have, like, God, you don't understand. And we blame him. We blame him for stuff. We blame God. It's like a natural sinful response that we have. When something bad happens in our life, why did you let this happen to me? When he's the one that's for us, not against us. Yes or no, amen? We're just crazy people. That's why we need a Savior. We need the Lord. And we need God's word to correct and help our crazy thinking. Amen. So, different message today. Only Jesus, just for us. Say that out loud with me. Only Jesus, just for us. I'd like you to place that word us with me. Let's say it again. Only Jesus, just for me. Say me at the end. One more time. Only Jesus, just for me. I want you to get it one more time. Only Jesus, just for me. Me. Did you know all today that we celebrate, today is also about you. This Easter Sunday morning, the resurrection, yeah, he did it, but he did it for guess who? Me and you. So we're part of this. Big part. That's what it was all about. Roger, help me, buddy. Let's roll. I want to teach you a verse this morning. It's important. It's a toughie, but I want you to get the gist of it. Would you say it with me? For God has made Jesus to be sin for us. Don't you say that again with me. Don't you let that sink in. For God has made Jesus be sin for us. That's crazy. Does the Bible say God so loved the world he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish? But the Bible says God made Jesus to be sin for us. But God's holy. He's holy, holy. Look at the next part. Who knew no sin. So God made Jesus be my sin. He didn't know any sin. That's why this is about me. This is about me today. He died for me. He rose for me. He died for my sins, not his sins, my sins. Only God could do this. No man could do this. Don't ever put your trust in a man or a woman. What are you doing? God made Jesus. Say it again. God made Jesus to be sin for us, who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of in Jesus. Oh, you don't believe in that Jesus, do you? If you don't believe in Jesus, you're shot. No hope. Do you see any other names in that verse? Say. See any other names? You don't believe that Bible, do you? I'd be a fool not to believe that. That's the best thing I've ever seen. Are you kidding me? Say it with me, the whole verse. For God has made Jesus to be sin for us. Who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in Jesus. I'm going to tell you something right now. You ought to circle that. You ought to write that verse down. You ought to know that verse. That verse will help you fight Satan, fight yourself, fight all kinds of crap in your life. That's incredible. That's a powerful, powerful verse. Only Jesus gets me. Why? Because nobody else did that. I mean, I've had people stand up for me. There was a bully years ago when I was a little boy. And I was little at one time. I started growing like a weed in about the fifth grade. I still remember Ken Grooms going to me one day and saying, "You getting big." Little kid. But there was a boy on the bus. And I lived in a bad part of town. In a rough area. And kid's name was Charlie Ingram. He was a bully. Big. Charlie like seventh grade, had a mustache, built arms. I mean, what the heck? And he would take our money. He'd take our money. I don't know why I tell stories. This ain't in the message, but we're going to go with it. He'd take our lunch money, 50 cents. And you give it to him. And that's the bus I was on. And I'm talking about nobody ever stood for me and gets me like Jesus. But somebody that reminds me of Jesus in my life is my brother Terry. Y'all know Terry. He's coming again. We're going to preach sometime again. It's going to happen. He's an electrician, but he can preach. But Terry was 6-7 years older than me. And back in Carolina, you could drive a school bus when you were a student. Like a senior? Oh, yeah. Back in the day. When kids, it was fine. We had no problem. It was fine. That's the truth, buddy. Welcome to America. But anyway, well, my brother switched with somebody and drove that bus. And my brother was big, big athlete, star baseball player. He dealt with Charlie. Yeah. Never had another problem out of Charlie. Jesus dealt with the Charlie in your life. Jesus dealt. He became the Charlie and everything else in your own life. The sin in your life. He became our sin so that we could have his righteousness. That's something special. Y'all hear me today? Is that too deep theology for you? Tell you what, Jesus didn't know sin, but he was made sin for me. I didn't know righteousness, but I was made righteous by Jesus Christ. Back up and say that again. Why don't you say it with me? This message is almost over. I don't have a long message. This is the message. Start it from the top, Raj. Back it up. Thank you, buddy. Jesus was made sin for me. Amen? Keep going. I didn't know righteousness, but I was made righteous by Jesus Christ. Nobody else was ever made sin for me. I want you to say that out loud a couple of times. Nobody else was ever made sin for me. One more time. Nobody else was ever made sin for me. Did my brother take up for me? Did he help me? Yes, but he was not made sin for me. Got it? Nobody else was ever made sin for me. Say it again. Nobody else was ever made sin for me. And this ain't just somebody. This is God himself became sin for you and me. But I'm not loved. I don't matter. What are you talking about? That's just our crazy head again. We got to know we're loved. Amen? He was made sin for me. Does Jesus get you or not? If he was made sin for you, do you think he knows you? Say yes or no. Oh, yeah. You think he knows the good? Mm-hmm. You think he knows the bad? You think he loves you anyway? Absolutely. Who does that? Only Jesus, just for us. Only him. We'll quit with this. We're going to read the scriptures. Then Pilate took Jesus. He scourged him. Just for us. The soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on Jesus' head. They put on Jesus a purple robe. And they said, "Hail, King of the Jews." They smote him with their hands. Pilate therefore went forth again and says, behold, I bring him forth to you that you may know I find no fault in him. But you know why? Because he was without sin. I was the guilty one. Then came Jesus forth wearing a crown of thorns, a purple robe. Pilate said unto them, behold the man. When the chief priests therefore and officers saw it, they cried out saying, crucify him, crucify him. Pilate said, take you him and you crucify him. I don't find any fault in him. But they cried out, away with him, away with him, crucify him. Pilate said unto them, shall I crucify your king? The chief priest answered, we have no king but Caesar. Then delivered he him therefore unto them to be crucified, and they took Jesus and they led him away. And he bearing his cross, that was my sin on him, went forth into a place called the place of a skull, which in the Hebrew is Golgotha, where they crucified him and two others with him on either side, and Jesus was in the middle. And Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross, and the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. Then said the chief priest of the Jews to Pilate, write not the King of the Jews, but that he said he was the King of the Jews. Pilate said, shut your mouth. I've written what I've written. Then the soldiers, when they had crucified Jesus, not for his sin, my sin, they took his garments, they made four parts, to every soldier a part, and also his coat. And the coat was without a seam, woven from the top throughout. They said among themselves, let us not rend it, but cast lots for it, whose it shall be, that the scripture might be fulfilled, which this was prophesied, which said, they parted my raiment among them, and for my vesture they did cast lots. These things the soldiers did. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple standing by whom he loved, he said unto his mother, woman, behold your son. After this, Jesus, knowing that all things were now accomplished, that the scripture might be fulfilled, on the cross he said, I thirst. Now there was set a vessel full of vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar. They put it upon hyssop, and they put it in his mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head and he gave up the ghost. He died. The Jews therefore, because of it, the preparation that the body should not remain upon the cross on the Sabbath day, for the Sabbath day was a high day, they besought Pilate that their legs might be broken, and that they might be taken away. Then came the soldiers, and they broke the legs of the first and the other one that was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus, saw that he was dead already, they didn't break his legs. But one of the soldiers did take a spear and pierce his side, and out came blood and water. For his sin? No, he didn't know sin. That was my sin. You understand the verse better? John writing says, I saw this. I was there. I bear record. And my record is true. What I'm telling you is the truth. I'm not lying to you, John says. For these things were done that the scripture should be fulfilled. A bone of him shall not be broken. And again, another scripture says, they shall look on him whom they've what? Did you know there was no crucifixion when that scripture was prophesied in the Old Testament? There was no such thing as crucifixion when that scripture was prophesied. Isn't that crazy? Only Jesus, just for us. You understand the message today? Is it pretty clear? Roger, I'm quitting. Two reasons he did that. Two reasons. Love, love. God loves you. He loves you. He loves you. Here's something else he had. Courage. He had courage. He had courage. He has a strong love for you. You hear me or not? How many would raise a hand and say, Pastor, many times in my life I've not been easy to love? How many hands would pop up? See? He's got a strong love for you. He knows all the crap you've ever been through, but he also knows all the crap you've caused. Because he gets you. He became sin for you. That's a great God. What should my response be to this kind of message? Here would be a good one. Thank you. How about, can we say that? Thank you. Wouldn't that be a good response to what he did for us? How about, thank you, Lord, for doing that for me? And how about, I'm going to believe in you. I'm going to trust you, and I'm going to live my life for you. Would that be a fair response, yes or no? Let's thank the Lord for his word. We're done. Amen. Come on, praise the Lord. Amen. Right there. Let's jump up on our feet. Amen. Thank you. Thank you for a good morning today, but we're not done. We're almost done. Listen, just like the beach, I don't assume because you come to church you're going to heaven. Why would I do that? Going to church won't get you to heaven. The Bible says, believe on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be what? That's what gets you there. Can I lead you in a prayer right now where you put your faith in Christ? Let's bow our heads. Right now. God, you made Jesus to become sin for me. He was holy. He knew no sin. And he did that so that I could be made righteous through him, through him, through him, through him. Burn that into our heart today. Today, if you absolutely are not confident in your faith in Christ, would you humble yourself right now? I've got a good feeling you're there. You're there at that humble place right now after a message like this in God's Word. Would you pray with me right now? Would you put your faith in Christ right now? Let's pray together. Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. You're not the sinner, Lord. I am. Your sin was none. My sin is much. And you died on the cross in my place. You took my sin on you. I don't understand it all. But Lord, I believe it. I believe it. I put my faith in you today. I promise, Lord, I'm not going to put it in a church. I'm not going to put it in a preacher. I'm not going to put it in myself. I'm going to put it in you, Jesus. Only you, Jesus. Only you did this for me. Only you did this for me. Save me today. I want to live for you. Help me, Lord, I pray. I don't understand it all, but Lord, I got this part. I got it. In Jesus' name. With heads bowed, how many would lift a hand and say, Pastor Gary, I said that prayer. I nailed that. I knew that. I received Christ today. Can I see your hand in this room today? I did that. I did that. I did that. I am not ashamed at all. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Lord, bless us as we go our way and have some refreshments perhaps, and bless the next service and this evening. I pray many today, Lord, will want to follow you in baptism tonight and live for you. Not a better day, I don't think, is there, Lord, than today. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys. See you later. Thank you for a great service here today. I had a great time. It was hard to beat that beach, but this was very, 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 very